Welcome to News Beats. I'm Annie Das. Our today's historical episode contains information on ancient city Agra, which is located in the northern state of Uttar Pradesh, India. The city is famous for being the capital of the Mughal Emperor from 1526 to 1658. It is a major tourist destination for its many Mughal-era buildings such as Taj Mahal, Agra Fort and Fatehpur Sikri, all three of which are UNESCO World Heritage Sites. It's generally accepted that Agra was both an ancient city from the times of Mahabharata, and yet nevertheless Sultan Sikandar Lodi, the Muslim ruler of Delhi Sultanate, founded Agra in the year 1504. After the Sultan's death, the city passed on to his son Sultan Ibrahim Lodi. He ruled his sultanate from Agra until he fell fighting to Mughal Badshah Babur in the First Battle of Panipat, fought in 1526. The golden age of the city began with the Mughals. It was known then as Akbarabad and remained the capital of the Mughal Emperor under the Badshahs Akbar, Jahangir and Shah Jahan. Akbar made it the eponymous seat of one of his original 12 Subhas, bordering Allahabad, Malwa and Ajmer Subhas. Shah Jahan later shifted his capital to Shahjahanabad in the year 1649. Agra was also known as Akbarabad in the Mughal era. The name was coined by the Emperor Shah Jahan in honor of his grandfather Akbar. Agra is best known for the Taj Mahal, designated a UNESCO World Heritage Site in 1983. The Mughal Emperor Shah Jahan built it for his favorite wife Mumtaz Mahal in mid-17th century. Agra has two histories. One of the ancient city on the east or left bank of River Yamuna, going back so far as to be lost in the legends of Krishna and Mahabharata, and re-established by Sikandar Lodi in 1504 to 1505, the other of the modern city, founded by Akbar in 1558 on the right bank of the river, which is associated with the Mughals and known throughout the world as the city of the Taj. The Taj Mahal is distinguished as the finest example of Mughal architecture, a blend of Indian, Persian and Islamic styles. The Taj Mahal is the most visited tourist spot in India. The chief architect was probably the Persian architect Ustad Ahmad Lahori, designed as a unified entity according to the principle of Mughal architecture. The five principal elements of the complex were the main gateway, garden, mosque, jabab and the mausoleum with its four minarets. The construction commenced in 1632 with upwards of 20,000 workers from India, Persia and the Ottoman Empire and the Europe working to complete the mausoleum itself by 1639, the adjunct buildings by 1643, with decoration work continuing until at least 1647. In total, construction of the 42-acre complex spanned 22 years. It can be observed from Agra Fort, from where Emperor Shah Jahan gazed at it for the last 8 years of his life, a prisoner of his son Aurangzeb. Agra also has several other places of interest, most of them from its Mughal past. They include the Jama Masjid, Chini Ka Ruaza, Aram Bagh, Mariam's Tomb, Mehtab Bagh, among others. Agra's cuisine is derived from its Mughal past. Mughlai cuisine mainly consists of meat enriched with creamy, boldly flavored curries with lots of dried fruits and spices. Vegetarian dishes using paneer instead of meats are equally loved. Taj Mahotsav is a cultural festival and craft fair that was started in the year 1992 and has grown since then. The year 2019 was the 20th year of this Mahotsav. The fair is held in a big field of Shilpagram near the eastern gate of the Taj Mahal. The festival also figures in the calendar of events of the Department of Tourism, Government of India. It was during the advent of Mughal era that Agra grew as a center of Islamic education. In the year 1823, Agra College, one of the oldest colleges in India, was formed out of a Sanskrit school established by Sindhia rulers. In the British era, Agra became a great center of Hindi literature with people like Babu Gulab Rai at the helm. Many major cities like Jaipur, Gujarat, Kanpur, Delhi, Chennai, Mumbai are well connected with Agra. A trip to Agra makes you feel proud of the tradition and culture of India. It's a sign of prestige and royalty. That's all for today. Stay tuned to our channel, like, share and subscribe.